to celebrate the Passover lamb and the Old Testament ritual with his friends. When he knew that one of his friends would betray him. did not yield to those temptations. He endured through those temptations. The Gospels also reveal to us the works agenda that Jesus had to fulfill. In the fourth chapter of Luke, verses 16 through 19, we envision how Jesus went into the place of worship, and he was given the Old Testament to read. And he announced his agenda from the book of Isaiah. To preach the gospel to the poor. To heal the brokenhearted. To preach deliverance to the captives. And recovering the sight to the blind. To set free them that are bruised. To preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Christ's agenda consisted of preaching, healing, preaching, recovering, setting free, and more preaching. And when it was all said and done, he said, it is finished. The work that I was given to do, it is finished. Tonight as we walk with Christ on his way to Golgotha, I think that it's important to look at three things. First, we'll look at the definition for finished. The dead representatives.
Watch out, God.
And the debt that Jesus paid.
All right.
First, the two definitions of finished can be pulled from John 17:4 and John 19:30. Both definitions come from the same root word. In John 17:4, it is teleihu, which means to complete, to consummate in the realm of mental and moral character. When Christ prayed and stated, "I have finished the work," basically he was saying, "I have finished the work of completing mankind's sin-sick character." and the victim was ordered to carry his cross, which weighed over 100 pounds, 650 yards to the place of execution. The rough wood gouged his back. Now he was already dehydrated. The miracle was that he was still living.
The
rusty spikes were driven amongst the carpal bones in the wrist instead of the palms, because the weight of the body would have ripped away the flesh between his fingers. Isaiah says he was wounded
for by our transgression.
He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. Dr. Bradley continues. This was the most agonizing death a man could face. He had to support himself in order to breathe. The flaming pain caused by the spikes hitting the median nerve in the wrist exposed up his arms and into his brain and down his spine. The spike running through the nerve between his metatarsal bones of the feet jerked his body erect. Then the leg muscles convulsed and dried his body down, beating him against the cross. Air is sucked in, but cannot be exhaled, because the buildup of carbon dioxide in the lungs and bloodstream has been stopped. Billions of us should have received this beating. Billions of us should have had spikes.
got me.
Like I said, you might say you don't have to do it, but you can't do it.
Tell it.